Hi, Shabbat Shalom. It's been a couple weeks since I've sent a message. I have been away. I took a short vacation and met with my kids in a home that was tucked away in the woods in southeastern Pennsylvania. We each drove there and we each went there after serious consideration of how we had been socially distancing and wearing masks, etc., and staying away from people. So it was safe and we had a lot of fun. There are a couple things that I'd like to talk to you about, what I learned on my vacation. Some are really obvious, but it's really important. And the first had to do with just being in a different location. And after months of being in essentially the same room and doing all of my work, to be able to go out and to be able to be out in nature was really very healing. And I have been suggesting and continue to suggest that you make sure you get out, that it's really important, even in this heat, to just take short walks and to be outside or to drive to places nearby that are where there aren't a lot of crowds or people, and just to be able to breathe the air and to be able to look out into the expanse of the sky. The other thing is an incident that I witnessed, which I talked about to our young families in a message that I sent them, and I would like to share it. My grandchildren, Aya and Manny, are 3 and 1 year old. 1 year old, and they have not seen each other for a number of months. But in addition to not seeing each other, they also hadn't seen other little people. They've been with their parents, they've been with adults. And so this was a reunion for them that was quite beautiful. It was actually unexpected when we saw their responses. So we were all in this house, and then Manny showed up with Gabriel and Seth, and when Gabriel put Manny on the floor and Aya went over to him, the two of them both looked at each other, and then they started to laugh and to giggle. And they took each other's hands and they touched each other's faces, and then they hugged each other and looked again. They backed up and looked at each other and started to laugh. And there was so much joy in it. And I realized that it may be because they've seen each other in pictures and on FaceTime, and it may be because their parents built up this reunion. But I also think it was because they hadn't been with other children. They hadn't been in a place where other people were touching them and hugging them, and it meant so much to them. We have to get through this, and it's gonna be a while before we get through this. And as we do, we also have to, you know, pay attention to the things that we're missing and the capacity to touch each other, put our arms around each other, to stroke each other's faces. It's really something that all of us miss. And one day, God willing, we'll be back to that with those whom we love and those who we feel safe with. So in the meantime, I wish you Shabbat Shalom, and I hope that you're feeling well, and we will be in touch, and I'll see you on Zoom, and look forward to our ongoing experiences as a community as we're preparing for the holidays and learning together and doing our Shabbat services together. Good to be back with you. Shabbat Shalom.